Welcome, Sandeep.
Thank you, Manish. Glad to be here.
I'd love to know, as a technologist, what do you think about running the edge? How do you think of managing applications on the edge, on the data center cloud? Where is everything being run? What exactly is the place that is called the edge?
That is a very interesting, very important question, Manish. I think first thing, before I answer that question, we also have to understand that edge in isolation means nothing. Edge without a back-end data center or cloud is edge of nothing, right? That doesn't make any sense. So whenever we talk about edge, we have to think about in complete topology where it has data center and cloud and something connected in here, right? Now, think of those as workloads for compute. Now, they can run on the edge. Some of them can run on multiple different cloud. Some of them can run on on-prem data center. So now there is, what should run on edge? These things have to be automated. These things have to be orchestrated because the sheer scale and time required, you cannot just do it manually. You have to think about geolocation. You have to think about latency. You have to think about the amount of bandwidth. You have to think about the data localization. So you have to think about, in terms of what is the compute power that is available locally at the edge.
So Sandeep, you just talked to us about how the edge is actually the edge of large computing backend and how it is changing the way, data centers will be operating. What I think is it's changing the network infrastructure, right? And what does it really do to the job of the network infrastructure designer? How does it really change or impact the network infrastructure?
So fundamentally, there are four things, if I characterize that. Number one is you're adding a huge amount of new locations, call it micro data centers, different type of edge, so different type of sizes and types of data centers. So adding huge number of new locations that need to be, that is number one impact on network. Second thing is, when you connect all of these new things and with a huge number of things, you cannot manage such large number of devices in a physical way. So it needs to be virtual, right? It needs to have things like automation and zero touch provisioning. The third thing is the STN and NFV is required to make it happen. The fourth thing is, now the security changes as well. As the topology and architecture and dynamism of computing changes, security need to be also distributed and granular, and it needs to be software-driven. So these are the four fundamental things that are changing in the network.
It's almost like the entire network is getting impacted. I mean it in a very positive sense, that every different aspect of the network, whether it's the hardware, the software, the networking between them, all of them are actually elevating. My guess is all of this will also impact how telcos design their networks and how they are actually working with providing connectivity and data center services. How are telcos changing their approach with edge?
See, what's happening is, in the telco world, it is the term that is called, used is multi-access edge computing. That basically is revolutionizing the access network, both on the fiber side, wired side, as well as the wireless side, in the mobility side. Now with 5G coming in, it is changing the edge also dramatically. And there are a lot of things that are happening in the multi-access edge space to make sure that telcos can generate more money, make use of the huge number of use cases that are coming, number of new applications that are going to be run. They are seeing huge, huge opportunity, and this is already being deployed.
Thank you so much for sharing all of this with us, Sandeep, and looking forward to meeting you at the edge.
Thank you, Manish. As I have to say, we are on the edge of a revolution. Thank you, Manish. Thanks for having me.
Thanks so much.